In this video, we'll learn how to configure the BigCommerce provider for your Dynamics 365 Intelligent Order Management environment. In this video, let's have a look at setting up the BigCommerce connector. If we have a look at our getting started, we've got third-party providers that we can go and configure, so we can go across and manage. That gets us to our provider catalog, and I can see the BigCommerce order intake provider here. Now, before I can configure it, I need an account for BigCommerce. So let's go and have a look at setting up a test account. I'm going to go over to the BigCommerce site. If you don't have an account or a site, I'm going to go across to login, and then you'll see it says get started. So I'm going to go across to get started. And in this case, I can create a new account. So I'm going to go and fill in my details before I can create my store here. Okay, I filled in my details. Now I can create my demo store. Okay, so it'll take a few moments, and now I'll have a few questions. I can say no, I'll be selling, for example, home improvements, and I can just say I'm not selling yet. So let's say we'll finish. So after the store's been created, we'll get an email in our email account to the store. So in this case, this is my trial store. So let's navigate across there so we can log in. Then we can log on. Now this trial store will last for 14 days, which is enough for you to start to explore. So this is my store. What we want to do is we need information about the API that we can get to so we can communicate between order management and the BigCommerce store. So I can go into the advanced settings and I can come down to my API accounts. And so I'm going to create a new API account, and in which case I'm going to create a token. So let's create that. So I'm going to say my IOM demo trial. And in which case I'm going to go and configure what the API can do. And so in this case, I'm just going to turn everything on so that we can use all of those capabilities. At this point, I can save, and it's going to give me my token that I'm going to need. So I'm going to copy all of these details and I'm going to put them in a notepad that I can use. Okay, so once I've copied those, I can say done, because now I have the information that I need to access. And we've got our store API account. So now that we've got our account created, let's go back to our intelligent order management environment. And now we configure our provider. So I can click add provider, and in which case we can accept the terms. So what we can do is go and configure the BigCommerce connection. So we'll go and configure this. And again, we need to go to the Power Platform Admin Center to configure the connections. So here I have my existing system connections. I'm going to add a new connection, and then we'll find our BigCommerce connector. Now this is when we need the API key that was created. So we'll copy that from the environment and we'll put it into our connector. Okay, so now we've got our connector. We'll open it, and now we can copy the URL. So we need that URL, and then we'll bring it back and we'll configure it into our connection reference. Now I'm going to save this, and then I'm going to activate. So activating will enable this connection. And so once that's done, I can save and close. Next, I want the Dataverse connection. And so likewise, we'll come back over to our admin center and let's get our Dataverse connection. So we'll open that. Again, we'll copy the URL. So we'll copy that whole URL and bring it back to our connection. We'll save. We'll activate. and then we'll save and close. Now the next thing is that we need the parameter, and the parameter is connected to our BigCommerce store. And so we can get that from our store number. So we'll see our store number in our URL here. So I'm going to copy this store number, and then we're going to bring it back into our parameters. So we'll say that this is the BigCommerce store number, and then we can save. So once that's saved, we can activate, which will activate our connector. Okay, so our provider's activated, and we'll see that we've got the active status. So now it's finished. If I close this, and if I go over to our installed, we'll see that we have one active provider for BigCommerce. So that's our BigCommerce provider configured all the way through to our sample store. We'll have a look at this next in a follow-on video in terms of how do we use that in an orchestration flow. Dynamics 365 Intelligent Order Management is a new application in the family of Dynamics 365 applications. Built on the Microsoft Power Platform running on the Microsoft Azure Cloud. To learn more about Dynamics 365 Intelligent Order Management, visit our community site, documentation site, marketing site, or our blog at these links.